Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's your boy Ron Trace, and we're back here with another trade breakdown video. In today's video, guys, we're going to be going over psychology and pretty much how I manage my ICT trading and how I don't go into the information overload. So first and foremost, guys, let's go ahead and start off with psychology and how important psychology is. I'm pretty sure you guys have watched videos, you guys have watched seminars, webinars about how important psychology is in trading. For me, psychology is the number one thing that I need to work on in my skill set. And along in my journey, psychology is the biggest thing that hinders me in my journey. I want to give you guys a quick, real examples, realistic. You know, I don't want to get up here and sugarcoat anything. I want to be transparent and tell you guys what I struggle with, what I struggle with pretty much, and how I'm going to actually overcome those struggles. So the first thing that I struggle with, guys, is profits. I struggle with not focusing on the money. I focus on the money too much when I'm in the charts. Understand, guys. Once this screen is blue, that does not mean that money is in your bank account. That's one of the things that I really had to grasp. And I'm like I said, I'm still grasping that now. I'm taking 200K challenges and up. Once I make these 5%, these 10%, even 2%, 3%, understanding that, bro, the money is not yours until you actually withdraw the money. You know, until the money is actually in my hands and I can touch it and throw it in, you know, throw it in the air. That's when it's yours. When it's on this screen right here and it's just sending your MT4 account, MT5 account, you know, as equity, it's not your money, because at any given time you can lose that profit. And those are one of the things that I'm pretty much wrapping my head around and learning how to think more long term, if that makes sense. Sometimes I find myself thinking very short term and just trying to make a quick profit just to get out the market when the market is offering me way more opportunities. So like I say, that goes back to not focusing on the money. Now the second thing that I struggle with is pretty much impulsive trading. I'm gonna be honest, like I say, transparency, guys. I still struggle with being impulsive sometimes and too overconfident. Like I say, this week here was a very interesting week for me. I did finish this week up about 3% on my 200K live account, and now I'm actually waiting for a withdrawal. But alone making that 3%, I wasn't proud of my performance. Pretty much, guys, I wasn't proud of the way that I was handling my setups. I was getting setups, and for me, my personal rules, once I'm up 1-to-1, I go break even. This week, when I was up 1-to-1, I was closing now. I was taking partials early. I don't do that on a regular day, on a regular trade day. I don't do that. So I'll end up breaking my own rules, even though I was up 3% for this week. I end up breaking my own rules. I didn't really, you know, perform to the max that I should have on a live account and as a professional trader, which I am. So those are the things that pretty much are hindering me right now in my journey. Once again, that's focusing on profits too much, looking at the screen too much, looking at how much percent I am, thinking about what I'm gonna buy next month with this profit. That's not the way that I should be doing this. I feel like other traders should not be doing that, focusing on what you're gonna buy with the profits when the money is not even in your bank account. Once the money is in your bank account, then you can think about, hey, I'm finna go take this trip here, and you know, go to, you know, Dubai, Miami, when the money is in your bank account. But when the money is sitting here on your screen is blue or is red, you shouldn't be thinking about what you're going to do with it, because first of all, it's not even in your possession, right? So that's the biggest thing for me right now, guys, is making sure the money is coming in my possession. Yes, I've made money on a MT4 account, MT5 account, live account, but if the money is not in my hands physically and I can smell it, slap myself with it, throw it in the air, it's not my money or it's not your money. So those are the things right there that help, well, not help me, but they're pretty much hindering me in my trading journey right now. And obviously I'm going to continue to keep getting better and learning from it. That's why I'm starting to do this psychology series, because I want to be more transparent with you guys and want you guys to understand that I struggle. I'm not perfect. You know, I know I post a lot of good trade setups, but guys, it's more than in the charts. It's more than looking at fat value gaps and order blocks. That's easy. What's not easy for me is handling my setups, not focusing too much on the profits when I'm up 1-to-1, going break even and not closing out the whole setup, because I see I'm up $4,000 when that's in reality that's only 1 or 2% of, you know, some people's account. So that's the first topic, guys. Now I want to get into the information overload when it comes to learning ICT and any other you know, content creators or mentor. For me, guys, I'm not, like I say, not saying I know it all, not saying I have it all, but for me, I have a model that I am very confident in. I have a model that I can come to my charts. I know exactly what to look for. And I feel like once you have that and you have that backed up by data, forward testing, back testing, and things like that, I feel like once you have all those things and components in line with your model and you're really, really, really confident in what you're doing, I feel like sometimes it's okay not to consume new information. A lot of traders get into the point where they want to learn every single ICT video. Yes, that's okay. Do your thing if that fits for you. But for me, learning too much sometimes can hurt you. Sometimes when I first started learning ICT, I was trying to learn every single model, every single formation. And I came to my charts and I found myself dealing with, he calls it information. Well, it's called analysis paralysis, if that makes sense. So it's called analysis paralysis. Pretty much when you come to your charts, you're always looking for this order block, this fair value gap, this supply and demand zone. You want to see this breaker structure. You want to see this liquidity. Looking for so many things to happen that you end up never pulling the trigger, right? And you always stay in that one stagnant place because you're adding so much, you know, to your model, adding so much to your journey, which is okay. But I feel like it's times to learn and it's also times to execute, and that's the phase I'm in right now, is actually executing. I feel like I've put the work in. I'm still going to continue to keep putting the work in, but when it comes to my model, I feel like I have a consistent model. I'm very, very, very confident in my model. Obviously, my model is working on passing challenges, making withdrawals. That's something that most traders never get to, so I'm very, very proud of myself for that. But like I say, guys, in my journey right now, it's two things that I really want to work on, and it's obviously it's way more, but these are the two biggest things that's pretty much holding me back. Like I say, psychology, looking at the profits, focusing on P&L too much, worrying about the actual blue screen when the money's not in my account. Second thing, impulsive trading. When I say impulsive trading, guys, I'm pretty much not talking about overtrading or revenge trading. It's more of just actually when my model is shown, sometimes I try to anticipate it too much, if that makes sense, because I'm so confident and I've seen it happen so many times. When they don't happen, I always find myself in that trap. Oh, I'm trying to anticipate this to happen, or I'm trying to anticipate this MS shift to happen, instead of waiting for the MS shift to happen and waiting for the market to come back to my entry. I pretty much start anticipating. That all just comes from, like I say, the human mind. Sometimes I get a little bit too ahead of myself. I get a little bit too overconfident. And like I say, that's something that I need to work on in my journey. So yeah, man, like I say, I want to wrap it up here. I'm going to do way more of these videos when it comes to psychology, things I need to work on, things I feel like other traders can work on. And pretty much, like I say, just sharing my whole journey, man. I know this video was a little bit odd, but I hope it definitely helped somebody along their journey. And pretty much, yeah, that's going to be it, guys. I'm going to catch you guys in the next video. And as always, thank you guys for supporting my journey. I'm going to catch you guys in the video, man.